Oh, forgot the keys. The spare must be in the mailbox. Thank God we have a trustworthy mailman. It's been a long time since I was here. See you soon, Echo.
You've discovered Nez Perce Valley grassland habitat. Open country for beginners and seasoned veterans alike. The meadows serve as prime feeding areas for both pheasants and badgers. Undisturbed grasslands with tall grass have the potential to hold a lot of small but also some bigger game.
Here you are. Long time no see, my friend.
Vitals hit.
That would be a good shot. Temple wants to keep his shooting skills sharp, but 200 meters? Way too far for a safe deer shot. Looks like there's a note over there.
Hey, Wallace. Don't forget to take care of the badgers wreaking havoc behind the lodge. Sincerely, myself, you forgetful geezer.
Thank you.
I shouldn't use this bad boy for more than 100 meters. I remember when couldn't tell the difference between a white-haired deer and a mule deer. Anybody used to tease me about it. Let's see if I haven't forgotten all those hunting lessons from Grandpa. This reminds me of when Grandpa went for a pheasant hunt and forgot to take a shotgun.
Dear River, I've already told you a million times, but I'll say it a trillion. Thank you so much for helping me with Bear Den Ranch. Restaurants always place their orders with me by email. I think you wrote down my email password when you visited me in hospital. I don't trust the Postal Service enough to write it down here. I couldn't be happier to hear that you started hunting again, despite your father's disapproval. You're an adult now. You can make your own decisions. When he found out you were hunting with me as a kid without permission and forbid you to ever visit me again, it broke my heart forever. So in a medical sense, this will help to heal the physical scars that share my heart tissue with the metaphorical ones. Do you remember Hollywood, the little fawn you named when we saw him no older than a few weeks? Well, that muley is an old gentleman now, and unfortunately, he has abnormal antlers just like his father. It's a genetic trait that would spread further. I have one request. Taxidermy him for this nostalgic old man, and put him right next to his father in the lodge. He is the only trophy I left there. The rest, I had my friend Bustin' Dustin move to a bigger place. Do you believe there's such a thing as too many trophies? I'll pay for this taxidermy, but for any others, you will have to save your own money. P.S. I wanted to shoot him many times, but every time my finger froze on the trigger, because I think of him as yours. PS2. I have so little to do at the hospital, I decided to draw a little present for you. It's a comic story about the summers you spent in Nez Perce Valley as a kid. I decided to draw some situations we never talked about, and perhaps it'll be easier this way. Maybe you completely forgot about some. Maybe some still linger in you the same way they do in me. Expect more. Your loving grandpa. Dear River, well... It was summer 2002, and 10-year-old River was about to spend his first holiday with his grandparents. River could feel the adventure and mischief in his young bones. Why has River never visited his grandparents before?
Wow! Dad! Dad!
What?
Asked his father.
There was a deer! Which one is a white butt? Mule deer or white-tailed deer? It has to be white-tailed, right?
I don't know.
Grandpa will know.
Because my father-in-law knows everything.
A few hours later, River was finally in Nez Perce Valley, and his joy was matched only by that of his grandparents. But not everyone shared their elation.
Grandpa! I saw a deer! It was probably a white-tailed because he had a white butt.
Mule deer also have white butts.
How can you tell the difference?
Wallace.
Richard.
I want to speak to you in private.
River was amazed when he entered the lodge. The walls seemed bigger somehow, and the animals looked alive.
Wait here. I've got something for you.
But that summer, there was one thing River was forbidden to even think about.
To be crystal clear, you were absolutely not allowed to let him anywhere near a gun or anything to do with hunting.
Richard, that's impossible. This is a hunting lodge after all.
You know what I mean.
Will you help me finish it?
Days went by, and River couldn't get enough of nature. He already felt it was his best summer yet, but it was about to get even better. That's how he met April and Noah.
Hi, I'm River.
Why do I always have to be the animal?
Because you're the youngest.
Poor girl.
Why? This is what hunters do, isn't it? No. Real hunters are ethical. They wouldn't make an animal suffer like this and not even retrieve it afterwards.
River kept making the best memories he could that summer. He was also determined to find out more about his mother, as his father and grandfather never spoke of her.
I didn't know my mother hunted too.
Oh, you found the album.
Why do we never talk about her?
You'll have to ask your grandfather about that. But you can ask me anything else, sweetheart.
But this secret had to wait for another day. Time flew by, and soon the summer was at an end.
Try yelling something.
Ahoy!
On the last day, they made a new friend and named her Echo.
from 100 meters. Exactly as Grandpa taught.